It was on this day, April 11, 2019, when Elon Musk SpaceX launched the first paid mission for its Falcon Heavy program. That massive rocket took off at about 6:35 p.m. local time from NASA's Kennedy Space Station in Florida, carrying a satellite for Saudi Arabia's Arabsat. More impressively, though, was SpaceX then recovered all three of the rocket's boosters, with two simultaneously returning to land and the third on a drone ship in the Atlantic Ocean. It was a feat that Falcon Heavy had failed to pull off before, particularly a year earlier during a demonstration flight that turned into a spectacle with that test payload that included that cherry red Tesla Roadster with the mannequin in the front seat. We got a good laugh out of that, but ultimately SpaceX had the last laugh. It's been launching commercial missions prior to that, but it was with a smaller rocket, the Falcon 9. The addition of Falcon Heavy was supposed to give SpaceX the ability to bid on bigger payloads. But the Falcon Heavy has actually only flown infrequently since its debut, failing to live up to its highest of commercial promise. And that brings us to our question of the day. How many launches has SpaceX's Falcon Heavy rocket made since it debuted in 2019? Just nine. Nine launches, 17 landings, 14 total reflights, if we want to be specific. But by comparison, the Falcon 9 has made 320 launches. Now, that has less to do with the poor performance of the Falcon Heavy itself and more to do with improvements to the lighter Falcon 9, which at the time could only carry around 29,000 pounds of a payload. But those improvements would allow that rocket to take on bigger jobs of up to 50,000 pounds. That's key, because while the Falcon Heavy could still lift more than three times that, more than 140,000 pounds to be specific, its nose cone was still the same size as the Falcon 9, and that really limited the satellites it could carry. As a result, potential customers really found more utility in the Falcon 9 rocket, which proved to be more nimble, and its reusable boosters, for that matter, had a quicker refurbishment and turnaround time. That was a plus for SpaceX. Now, in addition, many of the more ambitious uses touted for Falcon Heavy, such as flying passengers to deep space, that's now reserved for SpaceX's larger interplanetary rocket called Starship. And the other missions for low Earth orbits, that goes to Falcon 9, effectively leaving Falcon Heavy in that weird middle ground that no one really needs. Still, there are some experts out there that say it might be too early to write off the Falcon Heavy altogether. It still takes years for satellite manufacturers to develop new spacecraft, so it is possible that more vehicles will come online soon that are specifically going to need Falcon Heavy's abilities. Either way, the holistic success of the SpaceX programs combined show that the future of commercial space travel has actually found its footing.